say this too, and there is nothing better than to talk to you. If you have a problem, I'll be here for you. Cause girl, you always know that it's us against the world.
Welcome back to my channel. If you saw me last time, you'll remember that I was at the Massachusetts Historical Society. Now I'm in much warmer climes, and I am so happy to be here in Texas visiting my dear friend Amy, who I haven't seen since 2019 when I graduated from the University of Mississippi. That's where we met. We were roommates at Ole Miss, and we've just been to the George H.W. Bush Presidential Library in College Station. I think we could say go Aggies after today. We've actually been through like several college towns because we went through Waco, we saw Baylor. And so it's been a really beautiful day. And I got my presidential passport as a presidential historian. I took this with me, determined to get my last stamp because there are 13 presidential libraries from Hoover up. Obviously the Obama one hasn't opened yet. And so I was so excited to get my final stamp and the highly coveted, of course, maybe only by me, National Archives paperweight. And yet, ladies and gentlemen, even though I got my final stamp, they were very, very severe and strict because I'm missing one. And only because I went to the FDR, the Franklin Delano Roosevelt Library in Hyde Park, New York, when I was a lot younger, in 2006, before they started making these. And so I was scuppered by timing, and I now have to call the National Archives to rectify the situation. But if that is the worst thing that happens, I'm not too overly concerned. So this is an absolutely beautiful day, and I'm really happy to share my visit with you. We're on the way home now to Fort Worth, and welcome back. Let's get started. All right, so I introduce you to my very good friend, Amy.
Hello.
Amy, where are we right now?
That's a good question. So we're about 42 minutes outside of Fort Worth, wherever that's located.
Yeah, we got, like, this is a lot more urban, I'm going to say, than where we've been driving through today. I mean, you know, we passed some interesting areas that were more, rural. We say rural.
Yeah, rural. I would go with that. Yeah,
we're gonna call them rural. A lot of cattle, a lot of cornfields that seemed a little bit dehydrated. You were saying something about there's a bit of a drought, though.
Yeah, we haven't had much rain, so it's been pretty warm in the hundreds.
We've been feeling that.
Consecutively, so
hydration is important.
Yeah, lots of water.
And what did you think of the museum today?
That was pretty cool. I'm not a historian like Laura. I'm a mechanical engineer, it was a learning experience for me. It was pretty cool. I enjoyed like the wedding dress, you know, some of the fashion things I saw, more so than the politics, but yeah, it was pretty cool.
There's something for everyone, right?
I would say so.
Yeah. And I just want to say, you know, when she says she's just a mechanical engineer, she is breaking glass ceilings all over the place, is Amy. She's amazing. And, you know, she's also looking into a career in comedy. Let's not forget that.
I mean, this is like, I think it's a little bit early.
A little bit early?
Go that far.
Yeah.
I just have one appearance that was abrupt. Spotlight on me, and I'm like, oh, are you guys talking about me? And then I'm pulled down, so I don't know if that... It could be stardom.
Could be stardom, absolutely. I mean, as we can see from the very subtle flag on the landscape, you know, in the U.S., everything and anything is possible, right? So, you know,
exactly.
The sky's the limit.
We have a lot of patriotism. So.
Certainly today, certainly like this weekend, this is what it's all about.
Yeah.
And we got the Texas flag, too, over there, obviously a bit lower than the national flag, as is the way. There we go. So, yeah, so it's been a really interesting day. And we also, yesterday, I will never forget your face. Do you want to tell everyone what we did yesterday?
Oh my goodness. So, Laura talked me into going swimming yesterday, but not just swimming. We went swimming with the stingrays. That's what I was proposed, swimming with the stingrays.
It was an experience. I didn't just throw it.
I want to throw out that there were also sharks in the water.
Bamboo sharks.
That I had no idea would be there.
Neither did
the I. The shark was thrown out. And I will admit, I'm pretty ignorant when it comes to aquatic life. So a shark is a shark. So that was interesting. We had, I put on my first ever wetsuit, right?
Uh-huh, yeah. Always an experience.
I should say.
But still styling. Still styling.
Very stylish, very. And then we got into the very cold water.
It was 72 degrees Fahrenheit, and just for anyone who's interested, the English Channel is near 60 degrees, so, you know, I was feeling balmy, but not my Texas friend over here.
I've been in the South basically all my life. So our water, when we get in it, is like 90 degrees. We do not get in 72 degree water. I mean, if there are Southerners out there that disagree, I mean, I'm sorry, but me personally, I've not seen it.
I don't think they disagree. I was always the first in the pool and the last out, and I always got
I think it was just last month in June, we went to a friend's house and got in the pool, and I was like, wow, it's a little chilly out here, isn't it? And I had to get in the hot tub, and that's June in Texas, so, I mean, that says something.
It definitely says something, yeah. And right now, we're on 99 degrees, so, you know, I mean, we were at 107 at one point, so, you know, we could say it's getting cool. sweater weather. Yeah.
As you can see.
Absolutely. But no, I mean, with the stingrays, I mean, I really love doing those interactive animal experiences. I find it really relaxing as a neurodiverse person, that stimuli, and I can understand it's not for everyone, but it was the first time I was able to share it with a friend, and so I was really happy that you were there and part of that.
It definitely was a brand new experience to me. I felt overstimulated as the stingrays, they like came up
descended upon you
and they just like kind of were flopping on your body.
I love the wiggle. We love it.
And so you're just like, oh my goodness. And then we're feeding them fish, right? Like, and so they like suck on your hand.
I had like this little stingray scar. I don't know whether y'all can see it, but yeah, there we go. But you know what? I think I'll live. I've got 9 other fingers. It's okay.
That's a very important one, though.
Is it an index finger? But you know, I can't point at students and be, you know, like scary. So maybe it's a good thing. I can never be intimidating again. Not with that hand. It looks like the sun's setting over there. We've got like some really nice rays going on. It's pretty. Like the sun sets so earlier over here. You think it's about like 8 it sets, or
we lose light. I don't know when sunset is today, but I know last light's like almost 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
So it's pretty late. So sunset has to be around 8 sometime, I would say, the start of it.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I mean, it's so pretty.
I don't know if that's true.
Yeah. I mean, when I arrived, I felt like the temperature was sort of similar, and that was in the evening, that was around 8. I felt like the temperature was similar to sort of Mississippi in May. Like, it wasn't too much, but during the day, definitely.
Yeah.
You feel it. But not the humidity, as you said, unless it rains, and then I'm dying. But
it's so steamy.
I don't get the freshness from the rain. I just, you know,
you
perspire.
Walk out,
I get wetter. We went to that water park, didn't we? It was like a water garden?
Oh, yeah.
It was a water garden.
Yeah,
that was really pretty.
It looked really nice, and they even had like a wading pool, but we had already been wet like 4 times today, so we decided not to get in.
Yeah, that was definitely, you know, getting in and out of the tank and all that. That was, but highly recommend SeaQuest at Fort Worth if you're ever in town. Definitely a really great visit, and it was nice to see how many people were enjoying it over the weekend as well.
Water shoes.
Bring water shoes, you think? Yes. Do you think maybe they should have
shower shoes?
Shower shoes. I thought you meant like actually in the water itself, but no, the bathroom.
No,
that's a good point.
Just for like transport, just make sure they're not like cloth shoes. Like
that's a really good point.
Something you're probably getting wet, especially for the shower because it's communal, and I just didn't think about it. It just depends on the person that you are. So.
Yeah, I think that that's a really good point. You fed some really cool animals as well. Like, we got tokens to go around and feed the animals. And I enjoyed feeding the sharks. Like, you just dropped it in the tank. But Amy, what did you feed? Do you remember?
The big turtle.
The big turtle. Yeah. It was a big turtle. Yeah, and
it had a tromping force.
It did.
It did. I was shocked. I just figured it would be very gentle, but no.
And most of the things we were feeding, for the tortoise and for the iguana, it was all sort of vegetables.
The carrot, and it looked like zucchini.
Yeah, but it looked very fresh and, you know, healthy for them.
It almost looked seasoned, didn't it?
I don't know. Maybe that was you. But what we have definitely been embracing Texas in terms of what we've been eating the last few days. We've had a barbecue yesterday with music outside, al fresco. It was really, really nice. And then today we had I had chicken and waffles, so definitely embracing that culture. Amy is definitely better with the spice. I have very little tolerance, but apologize to any vegans or vegetarians or pescatarians, anyone out there who doesn't like meat. I think it's definitely hard if you're in Texas if you don't like meat, right?
Yeah, I think there's, like, in Dallas more options than there are in Fort Worth, probably.
That's good to know, because you've been saying that Fort Worth is really a nice place for events and stuff, but maybe it's not. Doesn't have as many options in terms of eating, or?
I just think Dallas is bigger, more diverse, more hipster.
Yeah.
So I just think they'd have more options.
With Deep Ellum and stuff like that?
Yeah. I'm not too diverse in Dallas. I've lived in Fort Worth, so I kind of stay on that side. But, yeah. I've been to Deep Ellum. It's a pretty cool place.
Yeah, there are a lot of really cool places here in Texas, but the main thing that I absolutely love is obviously seeing you, Amy. I'm so happy to be here. I've been looking forward to it so much. It's been so long, but it's been amazing to pick up the conversation exactly where we left off. And I know I've said this to you before, but I think it was Jehovah's Witnesses who came to our door one time in Mississippi and thought that we were sisters. And then they're just like, oh, are you sorority sisters instead? Because they were just like shocked because I guess we were getting on so well or something. And do you remember that?
Do you
remember them knocking and being like...
I feel like I blocked that from my memory.
Hopefully not in a bad way.
Not in a bad way. I just feel like I just was like... I just hate answering the door.
Oh, yeah.
That's
my
thing.
It's a bad thing to answer. Unless it's takeout.
My door.
Unless it's takeout, you ordered it. Yeah.
And then I kind of like for them to leave at my door. I wait. I'm like, leave it at my door, please.
The safer way. I've always wanted a little sister, and I found one here in Amy, so.
Oh, that's so sweet.
We have an amazing time together picking up the conversation right where we left off, and it's absolutely great. So thank you so much for joining us, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the vlog. Bye!
This is Woodshed Barbecue, where we stopped to have a beautiful alfresco lunch, and it was so nice that they had a band playing as well. And this is just before we went and spent the afternoon at the lake. Such a beautiful city.
So here we are at, is it Rockland Park?
Rockledge.
And is it like a state park? Because it's so pretty.
No.
Ooh, state park. Your hat.
It's just in Grapevine, Texas. I think it's like a city.
Oh, wow. It's so pretty. Are people able to swim here year-round, or is it just...
I think the park is open year-round, but I don't think you swim here year-round. I think it's pretty chilly.
Chilly as in... Now, we know your definition of chilly, Amy, but for anyone else out there, what is chilly?
it can get cold in the winter.
This is true, actually. You can't get... There are signs that say, you know, ice on the road, but that is definitely not the day today, so... Gonna be all the way down. Here we go. Glad we got those water shoes. So we're all good to go. And we have some waves as promised.
$11.99 at Dick's, right?
$11.99 with the coupon too. So we're covered. But oh my goodness, this is how deep is this water? People up there already chest deep.
It gets pretty deep out there.
Which is why they have all of the wildlife and whatnot. Absolutely beautiful.
fishermen are actually in the water.
Wow.
So we're gonna try and set up camp, but this is probably as good as we're gonna look before we hit in the water. So
I'll see you on the flip side.
So I am here at Fort Worth Stockyards, which is a great tourist destination. And I have just been doing some last minute shopping. Always great to get Christmas presents in early. And I'm now gonna do something that I never thought I was gonna do, which is I am gonna sit, I'm not gonna say ride, I'm gonna say sit on a bull. Because when in Rome. So if I survive that experience, then you're probably watching this video. No spoilers here. But it's a really beautiful, another hot, obviously, day, but absolutely beautiful. And this is a really historic area. Looking forward to going to the museum, and really great food, all kinds of stuff here. It's been so great to hang out and catch up with Amy. It's been such a wonderful trip, so just really excited to just make the absolute most of my last few hours here in Fort Worth. And I have been to Dallas before, but you really need to go to Fort Worth as well, because they are really different. So you could see down there, you've got some more of the historic district. So yeah, do highly recommend. So yeah, here we go. So I thought I'd show y'all some more of the stockyards while I'm on my way to the museum. And I've just ridden Maverick, I'm gonna say that now. it seems like all of the bulls have a bit scary names. You know, Maverick, Gunner, Shooter, that sort of thing. Very Texan, a little intimidating, but no, he was a perfect gentleman, so it was a very nice experience. Very cultural experience. And so here we go. And yeah, like I was saying, you know, if you haven't, I went to Dallas for a conference, as Southern Historical and Association conference. That was in, I think, 2017, all the way back then. You can see there's a lot of sort of like Frederick Remington style art here, very in keeping with the theme. And yeah, so I was speaking at that conference, and so I really didn't step outside of Dallas, but I'm really enjoying the Western theme here, taking in all that culture and history, and I'll keep you posted.
So I'm going to end this vlog here with clips shopping at the general store at the historic Stockyards in Fort Worth. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, subscribe, comment, and share, and I'll see you on the next vlog.